It's the Weather Xtreme video. This is the morning edition. This is for Tuesday, the 30th of November. I'm James Spann. An amazingly quiet pattern continues for the rest of this week with a warming trend, and it looks like now much of the weekend ahead will be dry. Here we go. This is the upper air look across the country. Again, this morning we have a dry northwest flow aloft. And we're starting off this day well down in the 30s, some spots in the 20s. Gadsden, 26. Pelt City, 28. Sylacauga, 29. Those colder values over on the eastern side of the state. But a big warm-up today. Dry air heats very effectively. We're expecting highs in the low and mid-60s this afternoon. Around the nation, again, awfully quiet early this morning. And not a single thunderstorm expected from coast to coast today. Same thing tomorrow. And day three, Thursday, maybe a clap of thunder over far west Texas, and that's about it. Rain for the next 7 days. Really not that much around here. Again, it looks like we're now going to be dry through much of the weekend. A cold front Sunday night will bring a little bit of rain, but as you can see, not a lot here. This is now suggesting rain amounts for the state will be 1/10 of an inch or less, as conditions are getting pretty dry here. And we should mention, today is the last day of the Atlantic hurricane season. It's been quiet, of course, through the month of November. It's quiet now. The next hurricane season cranks up on the 1st of June, 2022. So model fans, let's go. Here's the GFS. This is the 06C run, valid today at 4. And again, a northwest flow aloft, a sunny day with low to mid-60s. Tomorrow, lots of sunshine. A clipper passes north of the state. Highs around here will be in the mid to upper 60s. Thursday, how about low 70s with a sunny sky? That'll feel good. And the same thing on Friday, a sunny day with low 70s, just gorgeous. And needless to say, perfect weather for the state high school championship football games being played this week at Protective Stadium in downtown Birmingham. No rain at all. This is Saturday. The good news, the GFS looking dry. And again, this will feature a day with low 70s, and the European is in good agreement. So we're going to take out the chance of isolated showers Saturday. There never was much of a chance to start with, but it looks like a dry and mild day. And even Sunday now looking dry, coming off the GFS. And if this verifies, again, we'll be in the low 70s. So a dry and very mild weekend ahead. And then late Sunday night, early Monday morning, a cold front comes through. And that will bring a few showers, but moisture limited. Rain amounts will be light. No chance of any severe weather. And then during the day Monday, we have a clearing sky and cooler with highs back in the 50s. And a week from today, Tuesday, December 7th, troughing well to the west. Moisture tries to increase. Looks like the next chance of rain will be the next day. This is Wednesday the 8th. Got a surface low near Memphis, and that would be a pretty good little rain event if this verifies. We'll just have to wait and see. And this is the European. It's not as amplified, showing just some light rain for the southern half of the state. Then the following day, this is Thursday the 9th, southwest flow aloft, and again, evidence that we could see some rain. So the latter half of next week looking somewhat unsettled, but exactly how it plays out, it's too early to call. Rain for Birmingham off the European ensemble, the mean between 1 and 2 inches between now and the 14th of December. Temperatures awfully mild for the end of the week and the weekend, and then back to reality next week with highs in the upper 50s and low 60s. And the latest outlook from the CPC for December 7th through the 13th. And if this all works out, much of the country, including Alabama, could see temperatures above average. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video this morning. We'll have notes on the blog, the next video here by 3 o'clock this afternoon. If you can, catch us this evening on ABC 3340 News at 4, 5, 6, and 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. Have a great day and God bless. Hey, this is James Spann. I think one of the best parts of my job, getting to do weather programs in schools. During regular times, I'm in a school once or twice a day, teaching students, mostly in elementary schools, things about weather and science. It's a really great part of my job. In fact, if I wasn't a television meteorologist, I would be a third grade science teacher. But one thing I've noticed over the years, some children, not all, but some, develop a genuine fear, a phobia of weather, especially thunderstorms and tornadoes. To offset that, I commissioned a couple of creative members of my family to write a series of children's books about weather. And the first one is out. Benny and Chipper, Be Prepared, Not Scared. Your kids will absolutely love Benny the Bear and his best pal, Chipper the Beagle Dog. It's a really good read about thunderstorms and tornadoes and how it's okay to be a little afraid, but you don't have to be really afraid. As long as you're prepared, you understand them, you know what to do, and you take care of yourself. Information is very powerful, and that starts a process of kids overcoming that fear. And this book is a really good read for any elementary school student. My friend Ginger Z of ABC News in New York, the chief meteorologist there, wrote a foreword here. Jeremy Davis, an illustrator, really makes Benny and Chipper come to life. It's a great read, and your kids will love it. I would encourage you to get a copy, and we'll have future books with Benny and Chipper about things like thunderstorms and the science behind them, tornadoes, and hurricanes. So get your copy today. Right now it's available online at spannbook, with two N's, spannbook.com. And you'll see some other cool stuff there as well. Benny and Chipper, prepared, not scared. Get your kids a copy today.